Hi guys, my name is Kazan, welcome back. Today we're gonna set Photoshop on fire. I have prepared this black background to draw some fire on, but it's important to say that you don't necessarily need to do this in Photoshop. You can use any preferred digital art program, as long as you know where you can change the settings for opacity and layers and hardness on the brush. So if you find this approach useful, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will be making more videos like this in the future. Let's go! To begin with, I have already prepared some colors here. As you see, they go from orange to bright yellow, and those are the colors that we're gonna use in that order. I will post the exact color codes down in the description, but it's also important to say that you don't need these exact colors. As long as you start from orange, go down to yellow, and go down to bright yellow. That's all you need. Great. So the first thing we're gonna do is that we're gonna define the area in which our fire will be drawn. We're gonna do a big orange blob. First of all, go over here and grab the first orange color. You're gonna be drawing with that now. Then we're gonna take our brush here. And please notice, this is just a simple brush. We make it really big. And then, to make our big blob, we're gonna turn down the hardness of this brush. And we're gonna put it down on 20%. After that, you will go up here on the top on flow and you're gonna type in 20%. Now we're ready. We start drawing. We're gonna make our blob. We're gonna define the area in which our fire will be drawn. Make a bit of flames and concentrate most of the blob here down in the center. Something like this. Yep. And then to keep our big blob a bit more vague, we're gonna go up on Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Then you're gonna type in 180 pixels. And now it's blurry. But we still want it a bit more vague. So over here on our Layers menu, we will choose the layer which we draw this on, and we will go on Opacity, and we will turn down the opacity to around 70%, something like that. Good, now we have something to work with. One thing to mention is that for each time I'm gonna change color, I am also gonna change layer. And that's only to keep all of the colors separated so they're easy to change in, if that's what you need to do. So you create a new layer, so now we're ready to continue defining our flames. You grab the next color in the row up here. You keep the brush on hardness 20% and flow 20%, but you're gonna change the opacity up here. We're also gonna put that on 20%. Now, there is a reason I haven't talked that much about the size of the brush, and that's because if you have a small resolution, you might need a smaller brush. If you have a large resolution, you might need a bigger brush. So it's not that important. I'm just gonna show you the concept and then you can play around with it. Now for the next step, we're gonna start defining flames. And this is the kind of brush that works best for me. Now, I want my flames to go like this. We start defining them, and then we will continue to redraw on them. And as you notice, the more you draw on them, the more powerful they get. I'm just gonna do this quick. It's very quick today. You see, we kind of have the outline of our fire ready now. And your flames might look a bit more different, depending on the size of the brush that you're using. But that's okay. Let's add some smaller flames up here. Like this. And then we enhance them a bit by drawing on them again. And I think that's it. Then we go to our Layers menu over here, and we create a new layer again. And we go up here and select the third color. Now we're moving a bit away from orange and a bit more into yellow. I'm gonna draw a few details now, so I'm gonna turn down the brush size a bit. And I'm turning up the hardness to, whoops, 50%. And I'm gonna do the same thing with opacity and flow. 50% on both. And now we're ready to do some more details. But maybe the brush is actually a bit too small. So let's just make it a bit bigger. Something like this, yeah. You see the brush? Now it fits in the center of the flames. Now we can really enhance them. So now you redraw on all the flames again with this color. We will enhance all of what we've just done. The concept is we want to make the flames more vivid and powerful. And the thicker the flames are, the more bright they're also going to be in the end. You see, I'm still varying the size of the brush. I'll do some smaller strokes just to do some details. Only to make the fire more alive. And then we move back to our big brush again. Can even go bigger. So I'm just gonna do this really quick. We're filling out the yellow. And you'll notice where the flames collect, where they are more dense, we will also add more yellow. That's where the fire is the most intense and warm. Great. And that's basically it. We will go over here and we will make a new layer again. Then we go back here and choose our fourth color. Now that we're really moving into yellow, we can really start brightening this up. We keep our hardness, our opacity, and our flow on 50%, and we just continue where we left off on the flames. You choose whatever size of the brush that fits the best. You're still painting inside of the flames, so the brush should be able to fit in there. And again, I'm just doing this really quick so I can just show you the concept itself. I just keep filling out the spots that I want to be the brightest. We're just gonna fill up the bottom here, just like this. I keep drawing again and again. We're also gonna add some up on the flames up here. They're also gonna need some brightness. So we're also filling them up with a bit of yellow. Just throw it all around. I think we're getting there. It's looking good. Great. Now that we have this layer up, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna create a new layer. And then you grab the next color over here. We're gonna make it really bright now. And you just do exactly the same one more time. Fill out all of the flames where they are supposed to be the most bright, in the center of each flame, and of course down below. That's where you're gonna fill it in. Now it's really like the fire is intensifying. Now, if I had worked a bit more on the flames to begin with, this would look a lot better. But I really do hope you see the idea that you start painting the background and then you add more color and you add more intensity the further you go. So we're really getting there now. I feel like I've filled out most of the flames now with white. As much as I needed. There's just a few corners here and there. Yeah, I think that's it. Then there's one more thing. I want to add an overlay layer to define the colors a bit more. So create yet another layer. Then take your bucket tool and choose the last orange color we have. And then you fill out this entire layer with orange. And then you go to this layer's settings, and then you choose overlay. And then you go to opacity, and you type in 40%. There we go. Now it's really intense and really warm, this fire. But we actually lost some of our brightness when we did this. So on top of this overlay layer, we're gonna make another layer. And then you go over here and you choose your lasso tool. And you make sure that this lasso tool has a feather of around 80 pixels. And this may vary depending on your resolution. but you should just be able to do a selection that's very soft. And then you simply make a selection here inside the fire, right where you want the intensity to be the most bright. Just like that. Then you grab the bucket tool. You choose white as your color. And then you paint the selection. And there we have it, our brightness. And maybe it's even too bright. So over here on opacity, you turn it down to, let's say, 70%. Yeah, that kind of looks good. Okay, that's it. Now I've shown you the approach. You can try this for yourself. Maybe just put a little bit more effort into the flames, but I think it worked out okay. I really hope you found this tutorial useful. I will be making more videos like this, so please don't hesitate to write your good ideas down in the comments below. Maybe I'll choose your input for the next video I'm gonna do. See ya!